shut at the international marketplace. And that place is crowded. Crowded with, you know, tourists. And the cool part was LL Cool J was shooting. It's a crossover show for NCIS LA. Shot several, you know, scenes. It was really cool, and we're always like part of a crowd. I was a tourist, and so one of the crew comes up to me, and goes, "You and you." So he picked me and this other girl. He said, "Come with me." And so we had to go to this location, and it was just me and her. We had to walk across this ramp into a restaurant, and we pass by LL Cool J and Scott Kahn. They have to head down the stairs while we go straight. And that was all we had to do. And you probably won't see us, but right before they start the camera, we have to set up, and me and Kiana are standing like reaching distance. I could have pinched their butt or grabbed their gun or whatever. They had to, they had to head down the stairs, so we kept staring at their butts, not complaining. It was so neat, because it was a different experience from last time, because I was with I was in close proximity to the stars, but I was like in a huge, huge crowd, and this time it was just me and this other girl. And there are no cameras up there because the cameras are down the stairs. And so it was really cool just to shoot that. And they had to do it like 5 times. So yeah, had to see their backsides 5 times. And they were like pretty tight clothes. Very, very body hugging. Clothes. Okay. Okay, so that was pretty cool. I wasn't like about to faint or anything. If you want to see StarStruck, okay, watch my video with Johnny Depp and my girlfriend Joan. She was ready to faint. She was ready to faint. That was pretty funny. I thought it was cool. I mean, I'm not a big fan of those guys, but it was just so cool to be, you know, working with them and stuff. And, you know, as me and Keanu were walking across into the restaurant, there was some crew in there, and Chris O'Donnell was relaxing right there. So you're not allowed to talk to the actors, by the way, or take pictures or bug them for autographs. It's a big no-no for extras. So I can't take any pictures. Sorry. But I did take a picture of the real tourists that were like crowding and excited, trying to get in on action there. And it was a fun day. I had to run from gunshots. And it was fun, so yeah. Am I acting silly? Okay. So the director was kind of yelling at us extras. There was 160 of us extras that day. And he was saying, "This is not downtown Manhattan, people. You're in Hawaii, you're relaxing. You guys are walking way too fast." And yeah, so funny. And then he said, "People, you're running from gunshots. You're afraid for your life. Do not smile." And yeah, I was one of the idiots that had a smile on my face. But yeah, I was far away from the camera. You won't be able to see it. But I don't know why they call me for these things. I'm such a lame extra. I was having too much fun. Only time I ever got starstruck, really starstruck, was when I met my first motovlogger, which is Rob Spencerian.
Wow, Rob's checking out our viragos. Amazing.
Hey, everyone.
Hey.
aka 88 Hawaii. And I was so excited to meet him, and I was really giddy, like a schoolgirl. And yeah, that's when I dropped my bike. Oh, thank goodness he didn't see it. Yeah, well, I was pretty, acting pretty silly and lame, and but after I got to know him, he was just a really cool regular guy and a good friend now. And it's just in the beginning when you don't know them, and you just gotta realize we're all just regular people. I have the experience of being on the other side of the coin too, where people recognize me, and sometimes treat me like a celebrity. I'm not comfortable with it. So yeah, last weekend I went on a sport bike ride. I went on a ride with a sport bike group, and three of those people knew about my channel. And that was really strange. And the next day I went to a bike show, and I got recognized there by a couple people too. And show you how famous I am, one guy walked up to me, looked me straight in the face, and said, "Are you Oki Honda girl?" And I just had to laugh. I said, "Dude, she lives in California." And well, can't blame him. I guess all us Asians look alike, right? that was funny. But yeah, I don't know. It's just weird. It's just mind-boggling how many people have seen my videos locally. And it's very hard to comprehend for me. And I'm not very comfortable with knowing that. But, you know, people don't recognize my face, really. I guess it's my pink vest, mostly, and my camera. Me holding my camera, I guess that gives it away the most. But, yeah, if you guys see me, you live in Hawaii, just come up and say hi, no shame. And love meeting my subscribers and talking to them. And anyways, you guys have a great day. Headed to work. I'm very late. Talk to you later.